I always wondered what it's like north of the Arctic Circle. Turns out, this is exactly where we had to go to find the last indigenous people of Europe, the reindeer herders and guardians of the land of the Northern Lights, the Sámi.
You're looking at them.
This is not just a story about our time with the Sámi, but a journey across a land unlike anything we've seen before. Norway.
We found the softest thing in the world.
Some of it's softer than other areas. Oh no, it's actually all really, really soft. Look at this. It's amazing.
How fun is that?
And you get to have a little garden right in front of you.
I think the Sámi can teach us a thing or two about berries.
In hindsight, little did we know how true that was.
Come on, everybody, let's go on an adventure.
You heard what he said.
Are we ready and refreshed?
As we were waiting for our Sámi contact to get back to us, we challenged ourselves to hike the seemingly vertical mountains of Senja Island.
We've got this.
Needless to say, Norway did not disappoint.
I can't believe this place.
It doesn't even look real.
It's definitely bedtime for me.
Good night.
Taking a nappy sounds nice right about now.
Hey! Hey!
Happy face! Happy face! I got nothing, buddy!
So Bodhi has been talking about these troll marshmallows for a few days now. Turns out they're hay belts, but I don't think he knows that.
They're not marshmallows, them are hard. Wait. Marshmallows
can
have sharp teeth.
Senja also happens to be known for one of nature's most spectacular shows, for lack of a better word.
Come outside, right now.
What? Why is it?
Those are the Northern Lights. The Aurora Borealis.
Oh my gosh, it's moving!
Mama, can we go there?
We're here.
We're doing it.
At the Northern Lights?
At the Northern Lights. Oh my gosh, it's getting so bright!
Even though the Sámi inhabit this entire region, finding someone who could host us proved to be trickier than we thought.
Let's go check down there.
Stuck.
If we are not lucky to find anyone, you are welcome to drive here.
Appreciate that.
Something. We will do something.
Thank you so much.
Where are you going to stay this night?
We don't know yet.
The beginning of winter is a very busy time for the Sámi, and because she was the only one agreeing to host us, we decided to take on the 8-hour drive deep into the territory.
Check out waking up to this place.
Good morning.
Underwater? Are you floating underwater?
We're on stilts.
Look at how pretty it is here. This is crazy. There are totally reindeer out here somewhere.
These unreal landscapes bring us to our sponsor of this video, DJI. I'm truly humbled to have a company that's been such an integral part of our YouTube and filmmaking journey, wanting to support our art. We get questions about our camera equipment all the time, so let me give you a quick behind the scenes of this indispensable tool. What we have here is the new DJI Mini 4 Pro, and it just blows my mind what they can fit into such a small package. It only weighs 249 grams, and as you can imagine, traveling with our kids to the ends of the world can be very physically demanding, which has us on a constant quest to travel as light as possible. Its weight also makes for fewer regulatory restrictions in different countries. This is the first in the mini-series to have an omni-obstacle sensing system. This means that when using it in any of its autonomous modes or just while flying it yourself, it's a lot less likely to crash into anything. And while this is technically an entry-level drone, in this model they added 10-bit D-Log-M in 4K 60 frames per second, which to me is a game-changer. This means that you can use it as a beginner and you can grow with it as you push the drones and your own limits. For short-form content such as reels and shorts, it can turn its camera to allow for true 4K vertical shooting. On top of all of that, this little machine can stay in the air for up to 45 minutes when using the extended battery. Check the link in the description if you're in the market for a new drone and if you want to support this channel. To sum it up, this is an incredible tool without which our films would not be the same. So we just met up with our first Sámi, Ella, I think her name is pronounced. We're following her down this little path right now. Where are we going?
I don't know, but I hope there's some reindeer at the end of this road. Bodhi just goes, Mama!
What is going
there
on?
There they are.
That's a lot of reindeer.
They are collecting the animals from the mountains. Everyone owns their own animals.
Wait, the kids have their own reindeer?
Yeah, they have their own. If they are hard, then you can eat them. If they are soft, then they are last year's.
They are hard.
This is our way, this is our winter. So we eat lingonberry, potatoes and reindeer meat.
Elle is an incredibly knowledgeable Sámi guide. The first night we spent in her guest house, before moving on to more traditional accommodations.
How far is it a real antler?
Look, it dropped off because the reindeer lose their antlers every year.
This going boom.
What we're doing today is we're going to be setting up a lavu, which is a traditional Sámi tent, right here by this little beach along the river.
We will go here and cut the branches, and on that we will put the reindeer skin, so it will be really nice to sleep on it. It will take a while.
We're here for it.
Yes, okay.
The lavu is a temporary shelter still used today by the reindeer herders when following the animals' migration. It also stands as a symbol of the heritage, even as most Sámis have embraced a non-nomadic, modern way of life.
This is a really sharp knife. So we use this as a first knife for kids.
Though it does appear that some traditions never change.
Is that on mine?
Yeah, you can have it.
Bodhi is in charge of a knife now?
Apparently so. He's four, so it's about time.
Very good.
Imagine you are myself.
There's a whole hierarchy within a lavu, which we first had to learn about.
We have certain places for certain people. Here in this like entrance area is for the guests and for the dogs. This will be the kitchen area or the sacred area. So we never go walk on this place.
A natural fire starter.
Where are the beds?
You're looking at them. Wow.
They're pretty comfortable.
So smoky.
So in the lavu, if we won't walk, we will be crawling, so we don't get smoke in the eyes.
I don't know if I'm ready for my inspection.
Yeah, it's really good. I gave you the tough side because left side is harder to put than on right side. In the beginning, one people was hidden under the ground and one people was on the ground. Sometimes they can trick you.
Is that something we should be concerned about tonight, the underground people?
Yeah, you don't know this place, so you should think before you sleep that I hope I get a good sleep and that you are not bothering us this night.
Got that?
Noted.
Do you know what you're having there?
I have no idea what it is.
Lingonberries.
It's amazing.
Oh, without raining on us all night.
The hole in the roof is letting all the rain come in. I think we might have to take a rain check.
It's raining!
All right, get on in there, guys. It's get dry.
Abandoned ship.
Oh, great. Can we go again?
So that we always end up at dead ends.
This is a 18-point turn. Okay, that wasn't too bad. It was maybe only like a 7-point turn. There's a car back there, and they took the gate down. Should we turn around again? My 7-point turn. And here we go.
This makeshift barrier was part of their far-reaching reindeer fences. There was another reindeer camp, but what we really wanted was to find a herd out in the vast tundra.
Yeah, are we gonna need it?
This is where Isak comes in.
So Isak and his daughter, they are just showing us around here, trying to find reindeer. A lot of it is just not passable with traditional cars.
He finally spotted a herd. And I got to go off-road to take a closer look. Roaming through the Arctic tundra on the back of an ATV makes me think of how the Sámi have been nomadic hunter-gatherers in this region for many thousands of years.
Hey, what's up? All the reindeer.
I get on there!
It was time for a take two of spending a night in a lavu.
What are you guys doing here?
Eating lingonberries.
This is the most adorable thing I've ever seen. The kids are all dressed up in their traditional Sámi outfits that they wear for special occasions, which today is obviously a special occasion.
The Sámi not only inhabit Norway, but also the northern regions of Sweden, Finland, and parts of Russia.
These are all her mom's clothes I'm wearing.
No way.
Our guide Elle has devoted her life to preserving and sharing the Sámi's traditions of living off the land and passing on knowledge in the form of legends and the ancient form of song called joiking.
Do you see the rainbow? Double rainbow! Anna, you just said that she wants to teach Liv how to yoik.
Did the Bodhi also yoik?
Yeah, while he was eating.
How do you move in a lavu? You just crawl, you don't stand up because 3 feet above ground, it's just poisonous gases.
Okay, all right, Jeter Pants, move over.
Don't let the bed bugs bite.
You mean the underworld people?
Oh gee, I forgot about those.
Don't forget about the underworld people.
Great.
Did you ask them for permission to stay here tonight?
Underworld people, is it okay if I stay here tonight? Maybe they're just groundhogs. If it got windy, that's probably a no.
That we're not supposed to stay here tonight?
Yeah.
Whoa, they're not happy with us.
Let's get out of here. Okay, actually, time to go. Let's go. Let's practice all our stuff.
Liv, where are you going?
Good morning.
I am here. How did you sleep?
I slept okay. I mean, as good as you can sleep on a bed of sticks and reindeer fur.
Waking up to foraging for edible plants feels like this is the way it should be.
This is quite sour. You want to taste?
It's Sámi candy.
How's that?
Mmm.
He's like, I'm sold.
Nick, that's Sámi candy!
You want to try it?
Oh, sure. Thanks. You know it's good when he gives me this to share. Oh, thank you.
So what you see, they have ears like this and even bigger.
Can I eat this plant?
Yeah, you can eat that. That's pita grass.
Is pizza grass?
Yes.
Pizza grass.
Grass. I like that one.
I like that one.
Okay, that one you like.
This kid.
You can eat it. We call it chaga. We can make birch coffee of this.
Yeah, no, you're not much of a coffee drinker.
But maybe I'll change my mind for chaga.
Right.
This is archangelica. This is the Sámi medicine plant. When the Sámi came down from mountain to the town, they would have this in their mouth to protect themselves against to get sick from the modernized people. Yeah.
After successfully spending the night in a lavu and having learned so much in such a short amount of time, I feel truly grateful for people like Elle sharing their knowledge and traditions with us, adding to this enormous, beautiful puzzle that is human life on planet Earth.